Welcome back. Our guest is Ragashanti, fighting to keep Ragashanti live on air. So Raga, what's the way forward for you? What's next?
Well, the matter is in the hands of lawyers, and we want the Jamaican public, you know, they have their side, we have our side, so we want people to hear our side and to give us some support, you know. So we want people to write to the Minister of Information, the Honorable Darrell Voss, because he's the one who is the immediate supervisor of the Broadcasting Commission, and you know, tell him, you know, voice their opinions to him.
Some people are protesting for your return to radio. You are the organizer of that?
No.
It's spontaneous?
Yes.
They organize it on their own?
They organize it on their own. I swear on a Bible, I swear upon my mother's grave.
And t-shirts and all? Some people wearing t-shirts?
Yes, man. No, but people wear t-shirts come a birthday of Bash and all. You were there, you saw them. Mm-hmm. When I saw it on TV, some of those were from a birthday of Bash. But I saw it. Remember, I have like 94,000 fans on my fan page on Facebook, you know. So, you know, and people are upset about it and thing. And
they took to the street?
They took to the street. What are their
demands exactly?
Huh?
Do you know?
Well, they want justice. Well, they know about the internet part.
What is justice for them? You going back to the show? What is justice?
Well, we're working out that. There are several options on the table. One of them is, you know, I'm determined to be heard. I'm not the type of person who's going to lay down and be defeated. I'm a fighter. Mm-hmm. So I'm definitely putting something together to have the show on the internet, you know, under the umbrella of Tambourine Radio, cars. You know, I live my tambourine in my vehicle and things.
And you're not totally tearing down or anti-establishments and
no,
systems.
No, I believe
and
in
regulatory
the
bodies.
Of the Broadcasting Commission.
You believe in that mission?
No, you cannot let the thing just be, you know, slappy tidy and whatever, flashy dashy and all of it. It can't work that way. There. But what I'm saying, it cannot be that you are regulating and, you know, with classism and elitism and discriminating against people from different constituencies and insisting that the content on TV must be unidimensional as opposed to the reality that we live in right now, which is a multifaceted, multidimensional type of thing. Out of many, one people really does mean something.
Is your content uplifting people?
No, but you see, or can I be honest with you?
Yeah.
You see, that question, I always wonder why you want to put that question to me. Mm-hmm. Why does my content must it be uplifting? I am an entertainer, me is a joker, what is uplifting? But my primary goal is not to be uplifting.
Okay.
There are many uplifting elements of it, but Winfrey, them have a problem with my PhD and my doctorate. Them just feel, say, because I am Dr. Kingsley Stewart, anthropologist,
I should play a role.
Me is a joker. God say must work with the strength we have. Me is a joker. Come and make people laugh. And me are the king of mix up. I am not interested in Dr. Stewart. I rather shanty myself straight. Me love give people joke and take. You know, see, I'm animated and full of energy and full of vibes. You know, see, I'm up to come dress. But just like a PhD, you put my head out there and the glitter and be a thing. A PhD dressing that.
So you
that
are.
Below, my man.
You are contented.
It's my PhD. You know, I do what me want to do with it, you know. Bright.
Raga, you're contented with your work.
Yeah, man, I'm happy.
And you're contented with the state of the of some of your listeners, where they are at the moment, socially.
You see, there you go again.
Why
wouldn't you ask IT and Fancy Cat that?
I would. I could ask them that.
But you're still asking me to somehow give me a special circumstance.
I'm moving you now.
I must validate myself being a comedian and an entertainer.
All right. I'm asking.
I don't owe you that explanation either.
Raga.
If you don't like Raga, you just don't listen, Raga. Don't come ask me Raga. If I'm contented with the way what people are. Of course,
Raga,
I'm not contented with it.
I am asking you to respond to the allegation.
I resent where you are, come and ask
but
me.
But Raga, I'm asking you to respond.
I have registered, so I don't know about.
I know, Raga, it's okay.
I'm asking you to respond to
some of the allegations being made by your detractors about you suppressing and keeping certain people down. And I'm asking you to just explain that for me. I can't ask it in any other way.
And what I'm saying to you is that. I am tired of explaining it, and there is a particular construction there where there's some people who must explain themselves and there's some people who don't have to. I always like to use this real world anecdotal information to illustrate the point. A lady once said to me that she's very upset because my father did have an X5 and him go buy a range. And she said she's very upset. She said, that is awful. What, that's a bad example to the young people in the ghetto. That's farm materialism and mm-hmm. excessive material. If I have an X5, when I'm going to buy a range for? And I ask her, tell me something, if it's a bootstrap with 10 car and 2 plane, would you question it?
Okay, good point.
But so there is something in our society where it's automatic and okay for some people to do it. But when a ghetto youth from cassava piece, sing him tuna and sing him song.
Cannot
and
be materialistic.
I'm going to buy 2 expensive vehicles. Them find fault with it, and then they want my father now, or they get a bit, for explain why is it him have 2 expensive vehicles. And my argument is, them could stop explain, buy what them want buy, make them money, because other people not explain. So when people ask me, why is it you have a PhD, and you're an entertainer, or a comedian, me don't want to explain nothing no more. If you don't like me, you don't like me, go about your business, I don't care.
So all right, in the meantime, while you wait the outcome of your legal response, yeah. and your legal team, yeah. the work of your legal team, what will you be doing?
You know, well, food have to come in, you know, because bills have to pay, so I'm thinking of keeping some shows, you know, because you have to go out there and think, so I'm going to keep some bus it out show and probably some mix up and blender show, because I'm officially unemployed now, but food have to come in and thing, and we have the bills to play and thing along those lines, and I'm also, I'm seriously concerned, I really do believe that whichever radio station I'm on, they're going to still take set for me.
Mm-hmm.
So on some level, I think it is intelligent of me to come up with something on my own right now. Hence the tambourine radio on the internet.
Yes, I read about that.
Yeah,
yes.
Where them can go. So I'm coming with an online radio station, essentially. And that going to have some growing pains associated with it, as is the case with
technical
with business and things. So
technical or financial?
I'm both. Now, the technical, it's just a matter of surrounding yourself with the right people like you do so competent. But then financial in the sense that we just live in a day and age that give thanks for the technology, but as you're well aware, the technology is also expensive.
Yes, and I'm concerned about your listeners, your fans not being able to hear you anymore.
My fans not being able to hear me anymore.
They don't have access to the technology.
I know, in terms of internet. So the young people, they're very wired. Mm-hmm. And the people abroad, you know.
Phone and so on and so forth.
Yeah, they're very, so I don't have to worry about them. What I'm worried about, you know, a lot of elderly people listen to my show. A lot of, you know, people in the rural areas and things who are not necessarily, you know, this thing in academia about the digital divide, right?
Yes.
And so forth. So they don't necessarily have access to computers and so forth. It would be really nice if perhaps I could be on a certain phone that is showing digital content now. So perhaps I could negotiate with those people. And so
how is that you negotiate with Raga?
Huh? So that is possible. But at the same time, do not underestimate the resource of the Jamaican people, you know, that if this thing is on the internet, you know, they would find some way.
They will
way.
Find it.
They, if they really want to listen, they will find some way. You know that on my show, in rural areas, there's a lot of sound systems that play my show. A man named Raskava play my show up on a system in a maypen every day. You understand? So they'll find some way to do it. And I want to help them in any which way I can. So I'm going to examine the technology. And so, but I think I need to be in a space where, you know, them crisis people can't bother.
You can continue to entertain your fans and so on. What happened to your staff right now?
Well, with respect to my staff, you know, remember that when I left the New Start 93 FM, I brought them with me. I wanted to bring some of the technical people with me, but I wasn't the one who paid them. It was New Start that paid them, so I couldn't bring those with me. So anywhere me go, them go with me. I understand. Unfortunately, I am off radio now. It means that they too are off radio because I mean PM.
So they're unemployed.
They are unemployed right now.
Mm-hmm.
But I make sure some take care of them, I can take care of them. You know, it may not be as much as them get to if they're employed, but may I make sure some certain things take care of them, because I see them as my picnic, you know, as my responsibility. You understand? And anything I go to, them I go with me. If for me eat food, them I eat food too.
Well, I do hope that you'll be able to employ everybody in very short order.
Right. And
soon.
And of course, between you and I, if you ever feel to employ me for anything, rest assured. sure. Because if I ever reach a point where I can employ you, you know that I'll be definitely doing so.
Yeah. Rago, one thing I'm sure of, if you're on anything that I'm doing, whether it be this show or whatever, everybody will be watching or listening. But
I certainly will not be lacking in energy.
But, of course. But I would need a big legal team, Raga.
Huh?
A big legal team with enough money to deal with it.
Well, that's a matter that, you know, we can discuss in
other I love this show. Mr. Love that show, yeah. Whoa.
Raga Shanti. Just
wait
one. Much respect, sir, for coming to and talking to us.
Yeah, man. I'm just want to say bless up to the Mix Up and Blender family and the Tambourine Nation. And big up on yourself and go on one song. All I'm a ghetto people, I'm a ghetto whites. A strength to say, a proper thing. See, there it goes, sir.
All right. And I will let you know, Raga, that there are people too. Right? You're on stage. You're on all the time.
Me know, because them give it to your program too sometime. Too.
Yeah, they give it to my program. Yeah. But so, the same people, the same Jamaican people. Love you all. Winfred Williams, on behalf of all of us, thanking you for joining us. Do join us again next week for more on stage.
You're a mix up and blender king. Let me tell you something. No weapon that is formed shall prosper.